What is going on? Here we go, another World War Z video. Gonna bring you the second part of the game here. Well, the continuation of my last playthrough. We'll run really fast down this alleyway and try and grab these file folders, but I got 2 out of 3. All these zombies jumping off the roof or something, I don't know. But that's kind of weird. Just like a sea of non-stop zombies just leaping out the window. I guess it looks kind of cool graphically, but still, I don't know. Kind of weird. But anyway, get through this alleyway here. Hopefully survive these zombies. These beasts are strong, but look at, they're like flipping cars over there. Crazy. Well, here we go, up the ladder. Oh, damn, missed the file folder. Grab those file folders whenever you see them. They give you XP, and XP is needed to buy upgrades and new weapons and such. I can't buy new health packs. You need to buy gold. I need gold to buy those. And so far, the only way I found to get gold is to actually pay real money, which I'm not going to do. The game already costs $5. I'm not going to put any more money into it. That's just ridiculous. You can, of course, find life packs along the way. So I hate this melee. I suck at it. I get bit. I get hurt all the time. Just don't understand it. Half the time a dodge button doesn't work. Hopefully in an update that'll be fixed. Did you see that zombie horde? Holy crap, that was huge. That's one thing I like about this, is it really makes you feel like you're being chased by it. Like every zombie in the city. The graphics aren't the greatest, but they do a good job of rendering a lot of bodies of zombies coming at you. So go ahead and click this radio when you get to this part. You'll talk to Troy. Troy apparently has a helicopter, and you can fly it, and if you can get to him in time, he will fly your ass out of the city. Which, obviously, highly recommended. So, anyway, not about gameplay, but I guess I feel kind of stupid. I never even heard of World War Z, but the movie comes out like this week, apparently, and the book came out a little while back. The guy who wrote this zombie apocalypse survival guide or some shit, I don't know. I'm sure you've all heard of it, but he's the one who wrote this World War Z novel about this giant world war that we all fought against the zombies. And that's what the movie with Brad Pitt is based on, and that's what this game is obviously based on. This is supposed to be like a movie tie-in game. So kind of want to see the movie now just to see what's going on, but I don't know, as far as movie tie-in games go, this one seems pretty good so far. It could be a good standalone, just a zombie apocalypse game, even minus the World War Z title and franchise. I get a little confused here because there were no little fingers telling me what to do. I really like those fingers, you know, showing me where to go. But I realized that I just gotta figure some stuff out for myself. So I go here and read my email again, get some experience, and check the file folders for some golden tickets. Those golden tickets get you experience. Like I said, the more experience, the better. And look around some more like an idiot until I realize you can go through the door to my right. Got a shiny little thing there, I guess, was what made me think to hit it. That's just light shining through. Anyway, here we go again. Back out into the warehouse, looking for the exit. This part is nice. There's not a lot of zombies popping out at me, so you get to explore a little bit. You gotta find the code for this. Keep it. I just try a random code because I didn't know what I was doing. Obviously, red light means no go. Now I have to find out how to open that door. So what you gotta do is head back down into the warehouse, as I will hear in a minute. And head all the way back down the ramps. You're exploring along the way, see what you can find, and then eventually, oh, that's right, I forgot about this guy. This guy jumped out the window at you. Another melee scene, which I hate because I suck. I can't dodge, I can't push him back. I'm not good at it for whatever reason. I'll get the hang of it. So off to the left down here, you will see a little push cart. Push that cart forward. Go ahead, pick up the ammo, and after you're done looking around, head back to the push cart and click it to climb up it and climb up these, whatever did you call these wooden crate things into this room. Grab the experience and head over to, oh, get a phone call first. That's right. Troy calling to see if you're still alive, which we are. He's explaining that he has a medical chopper and he's gonna get us out of here as long as we can stay alive, which we will, we're a badass. And then he says, see you soon if we don't get ourselves killed first, which we won't, because we gotta get to Japan to see our son. So go to the whiteboard, grab the golden ticket, and there you have your code, 9487. Now we can head back to the door, but you cannot climb back down the pallets, as I found out. So you have to find another way down. I'll look around a little bit, and you will eventually realize here in a minute that there is a way to open another door inside the office with your crowbar. So you go click on the door, then you can pry off the boards with your crowbar here, which will open these doors up. And bring us back down to the keypad. I had to go back here because, like an idiot, I forgot the 4-digit passcode. But got it now, 9487. Hit OK. And the door's open. Yay, we made it through that part of the warehouse. Go ahead and just explore this room here. Find the golden tickets, look in the file folders, check all the computers, and check the desks, and get as much experience as you can. Alright. So head out the door here, and that sequence get a bunch of shadow zombies running at us in the loading screen, and now we are back out behind the warehouse, and Troy is calling us again to make sure we're alive. He unfortunately had to listen to a zombie tear apart a girl over the phone who was trying to get to him also. That was pretty gruesome. This is where I will end this playthrough. and I'll pick it up in episode 3 right from this spot outside the warehouse, and we'll see what kind of fun we can get into taking on the zombie horde. Until next time, this is Tywin the Vile. Like it if you enjoyed it, comment below if you have any questions or something you want to see. Peace.